Tonight, we make three mega stops: Hollywood, Bollywood, and the Middle East. We hang out with Yousra, BASSEM YOUSSEF, Laila Elwi, and today's hottest Arab stars on the red carpet. Then, Chanel brings fashion icons like Rita Ora to town for the little black jacket. Plus, the cast of Shootout at Wadala get candid with us during our mega sit-down. And confessions right from the mouth of rock's most iconic frontman, James Hetfield. Now that's entertainment.
Who's there for the restless?
That was Bon Jovi's new video from their album's title track, What About Now? Hey guys, I'm Marwan DJ Bliss, so it is official. Thanks to our friends at Flash Entertainment, they are flying down Riri to Abu Dhabi for a super hot performance. We've got more details on that later, but right now, I'm just loving this week's episode, which by the way is filled with exclusive one-on-ones from actors to rockers, from fashion to film, from east to west. It's going to be one episode you won't forget. And to kick off the show, Dina joined her fellow Egyptian stars this week at a red carpet that was so hot, it was sizzling with some of the Arab world's most famous and influential entertainers.
Egypt's celebrity magazine Enigma is officially launching tonight, and I'm here amidst all the action to catch some of the Arab world's biggest stars. And here they come. We're talking screen legends like Yousra, Laila Elwi, Khaled Al Nabawy, to iconic singers like Samira Said and a host of multi-talented performers. And with their smoking hot looks, we couldn't resist asking how they get red carpet ready.
It takes a lot of Louis Vuitton, that's what it takes. I have a great stylist with me, Gehad Galal, and she styled me in Louis Vuitton shoes, Louis Vuitton dress, Louis Vuitton bag.
You're a walking advertisement, and look at that hair. That hair is amazing. How long does that take?
No, it didn't take long, like half an hour, and it's not as heavy as it looks.
What do you have to do always to get ready for the red carpet? Who's helping you out?
Nothing, just put my tie.
You sleep very well. Of course, you wear your makeup, you do your hair, you do your sauna, everything.
And how long does it take you to get ready for the red carpet?
I think 1 hour and half. Spent like 4 hours getting ready, doing my hair and makeup just to look like that. How do people
like
it?
Well, that's nice to hear. I love the bag. Can we just show the camera the bag first of all?
Well, the bag is quite fashionable, I know, but it's a tool. So if anybody knows me, I show the other face.
Now, just lastly, what's one thing you always have to do before you walk the red carpet?
I call my mother and I take photos and I tweet.
And speaking of tweets, with about 1.5 million followers on Twitter, the host of the Arab world's most popular TV show, BASSEM YOUSSEF, was undeniably the man of the hour. He was awarded this very month as one of Time magazine's most influential people of the year. And as one of my personal heroes, I was stunned when he recognized me.
Oh, I am a big fan. I show you all the time.
I'm sure you do.
Yes, I do.
And while BASSEM YOUSSEF may be making international headlines for representing the Arab world, he certainly wasn't alone in spreading a positive message.
The Arab world is full of incredible potential, and just like we have been very unlucky in the recent decades that we have been misrepresented, and people in the Western world who actually use this in their own interest in order to make their people think or maintain this kind of an idea for the Arab world. The Arab world is a much more diverse place, and like any place in the world, it has a good side and a bad side. So we just want to concentrate on the good side.
Arab world is the jewel of the whole world. And I promise you, they didn't still discover it yet. It's an amazing world.
We're not what we're portrayed in the media. So I think we'll do this through art.
As I always say, the Arab world is a great place. Great people, great brains. But we need to use it properly. Till now we don't use our resources. And the most important of our resources is the people, our brains. We need to use it.
and they are doing great in Dubai.
And of course, there is no way we were going to let these A-listers go without getting the exclusive lowdown on what they're up to next. Hey, what are you doing next? What's your newest project? What can we see you in?
My new project is that I'm changing the name now of the new project. So it might be Ta'am al-Dunya, it might be Halawat al-Dunya. Instead of إنهم لا يأكلون الخشب. So I hope they like it. It's Tamer Habib, the writer, and the director is Ghada Salim, who made خاص جدا for me.
I have a contract. I need to continue my contract. I have a whole lot of episodes that I need to shoot and to write. Hopefully, we're gonna continue doing it.
I'm doing an Egyptian song, a new Egyptian song. I'll be shooting it very soon. And it's beautiful, I love it. It's so like hyperactive, very attractive.
Right now, I just finished shooting an independent movie. It's called Villa 69, it's Egyptian. And I'm with Khaled Abu Naga and Gliba. And it's, the director is called Aitan Amin.
I'm working on a TV series for Ramadan with a great star, Ghada Abdelrazzaq, and like huge fan entourage. And I did a new video, and that's in English. It's called Breaking Me Down. This is a new single that's gonna be in English for the first time. And then I have a kids song and a normal love song that's a bit like Buddha Barish, Café Del Mar. And then I'm just gonna probably enjoy the Ramadan. After Ramadan, there's the movie, and it's a scary movie for the first time.
So I'm waiting for The Citizen to come out commercially in the States in the summer, and I hope at the same time in Egypt and the Arab world.
Coming up, John Abraham, Anil Kapoor, Manoj Bajpai, and the cast of Shootout at Wadala reveal some of the juicy behind-the-scenes secrets. And we see another side to a rock legend as James Hetfield talks fatherhood, rehab, and regrets. That is all coming up next. And that was just a taste of Imran Khan's hot new video for Satisfyer, which was not only filmed in Dubai, but will also be premiered along with our behind the scenes on That's Entertainment next week. Now, keeping up with the stars, some of the hottest fashion icons attended Chanel's Little Black Jacket Bash, including a little someone you may have heard of called Rita Ora.
It was the hottest fashion invite in town. Chanel's Little Black Jacket exhibition made its latest headlines in the heart of downtown Dubai, where fashionistas from all over the region flocked in to take part in the bash of the year. A few familiar faces also dropped by, including model actor Gaspar Ulier, trendsetting twins Haya and Sama Abu Khadra, and of course the star of the event, the chart-topping Rita Ora. A little earlier in the day, we managed to catch up with a couple of the starlets to find out what it's like to work with one of the most legendary designers of all time, Karl Lagerfeld.
He took the time, even if he had to be quick, he takes the time to really care about you, and it's not like, you know, sometimes in the fashion industry, like, people are really, you know, they have to do everything quick and they're not getting really personal with you. And in this case, it was quick, but he was like really, really nice.
I couldn't believe it, you know, the fact that he kind of knew who I was even was incredible. You know, I went to see his show in Paris, and I went to watch the amazing Chanel shows, which are incredible. You know, every season, every show, it's a different theme. It's awesome. It looked like a Disney movie. It was just so make-believe. And I went and met him backstage. And literally as soon as I met him, it was kind of like, I just said, oh my God.
But imagine inspiring Karl Lagerfeld so much that he takes the personal initiative to design a dress just for you.
When Karl designs you a dress, you kind of have to just stop the press.
In addition to being considered a style icon, Rita continues to be one of many celebrity faces of Chanel. However, when it comes to her own fashion inspirations, Rita says everyday life and people help her set her own trends.
Normal people I see on the streets, You know, I always walk around on the streets, even though people are like, you do. I kind of go sometimes hooded up.
With your hoodie, yes.
Or sometimes I just walk and people just say, hey, and I say, hey. And I just love feeling energy, you know, like feeling your energy and looking at shows, going to the theater, you know, watching drama pieces, movies, you know, it's all about, you know, people and interacting and the energy I get from them. But idols, you know, Gwen Stefani has kind of been my favorite since I was young, you know. No Doubt is like my favorite band. And I grew up really just becoming obsessed with music and how similar it is with fashion.
Now, whenever we have any Bollywood hunks on That's Entertainment, like Akshay Kumar, Salman Khan, or Ranveer Singh, we are bombarded with messages from our female viewers. So I am expecting the same will happen when I announce that Mr. Six-Pack himself, John Abraham, is on our show tonight.
Oh, come on, Marwan. There's more to him than a six-pack, like an eight-pack. Anyway, the stars at Shootout with Wadala. We're here in Dubai with some eye candy for the men, including a certain Sunny Leone and an adorable Sophie Chaudhry. You guys have such a big cast with so many big names. Is that a good thing for you guys, or do you sometimes feel like, you know, egos get in the way, different opinions? How do you feel about that?
I'm happy to be here with, you know, the whole cast and crew here. It's absolutely a dream come true.
Sunny, this is not gonna work. We need to kind of create some, you know, I can't stand you, you can't stand me.
I can't stand
I
you.
Can't
She was actually wearing, I was wearing the same dress.
Yeah, and like we can't stand each other. And like that's a major ego clash. And you know, like that.
Two hot women going at it. Let's do it. I'm feeling this.
Just the men have to work on the, they work on the egos and they control it. Women just let it out.
So are you telling me there was no squabbling on set? You guys weren't bickering over anything?
I was the cribber because, you know, the song Without Me, as I said, you know, so. Manoj and me were not involved in the song, so that was the only ego clash which we had.
Yes.
Very upset with John and Tushar and
Tushar Kapoor
and Siddhant and.
Well, I read somewhere that you were quite jealous because
because you see the thing is, very jealous, not very jealous. I was very jealous because I wanted to perform with Sophie, with Priyanka, and with Sunny, and of course Kangana also. He's got quite a few love making scenes also with Sunny. Over to John.
Don't try to hide from this.
Well, I also was very jealous and bitter because I was kicked out of a song because I wasn't available at the stipulated time. And Ala Re Ala. So yeah, we've all, I think each one has his own issues, but none of the issues are kept inside. I can voice it because I love the song and I'll be jealous all my life, I guess.
Yeah. 1, 2, 3.
Now you two, I do have a question directed at both Anil and John. You're portraying real characters. This is obviously a movie based on a true story. What does it feel like? Did you meet any people who've encountered these characters? How do you feel that they might actually be watching the movie?
Well, the character which my character is based on, of course I met him. I spoke to him, spent some time with him. And met his family also, and he's been of great support and quite helpful, and it really helped, and it was great to do a real life character. But unfortunately, we had to change his name, so it was now it's Afaq Bagra, which is good in a way because I feel somewhere, you know, because it is somewhere a hybrid of fiction and fact. So you know, so except for Mania Surve and Munir's character, basically Tushar and John, rest all of us characters have been somewhere, they have been fictionalized. So that's where we are. And it was fun doing this film, and it was great doing this film.
Mujhme hi khujli thi itihas badalne ki. Mera naam Manya Surve.
We'll be right back.
इतिहास मैंने बदला था। उस दिन तक बॉम्बे पुलिस के हाथ कायदे और दायरे ने बांध रखे थे, मैंने वो हाथ खोल दिए। ये कहानी उस पहले पुलिस इनकाउंटर की है।
When I heard about Manya Surve, I realized that fact is stranger than fiction. And this guy led a very interesting life. He ruled Bombay for 4 years and he had 12 confidants around him. But no one knew where he lived. And he used to operate alone. And the only person who knew where he lived and gave him away was the woman he loved. So there's a tragic love story that's beautiful. The characters are beautiful. His best friend's amazing in this film, that's played by Tushar, who actually helps him get out of jail. So I think there's a lot of respect that he has for the guy who finally kills him in the encounter. And there's a lot of respect between the two in their own domains. That's Afaq Bagran's character and mine. He tries to get into a gang that's ruled by Zubair. And how he encounters him, how he meets him, how he meets his mistress there, and how he finally, his rise happens where he has this lovely item song. So everything's beautiful and it was an experience playing this.
I was watching the trailer, there's no way we can't mention this. John, your run, that like slow motion Baywatch run, you know, the shirt off. Is that something you guys enjoyed? Is that intimidating? What is that like all the time?
It wasn't on the beach. In fact, it's a documented fact in the film where this guy was actually training when his best friend was being beaten up somewhere. So what we've shown is actually factual. There was no intent to show the body. And I think we've tried to steer clear of the physicality as much as possible and concentrate on performances, and I'm sure that'll come through.
We get intimate with Metallica's James Hetfield during his rock out session in the Emirates. That is rolling out next. American Music Awards, 7 Grammy Awards, 18 Billboard Music Awards. This Barbados beauty is one of today's hottest singers. So after bringing some of the world's biggest acts to perform here in the UAE, it's no surprise that Flash decided it was high time to make Rihanna's huge local fan base very happy.
Well, the reaction's been unbelievable. Rihanna played for us in 2009 New Year in Abu Dhabi, which was an amazing show. And since then, I think it's safe to say she's been one of those artists that on Facebook, on Twitter, when we have surveys and polls on who you'd most like to see come back to Abu Dhabi, she's right up there.
And for those of you who are ready to camp out to be first in line, we wanted to make sure you got the essential dates and details first.
So Rihanna performs on the 19th of October, it's a Saturday, at the Du Arena on Yas Island in Abu Dhabi. Tickets will go on sale on the 9th of May at midday from Ticketmaster.au. Ticket prices, $395 for general admission. We have Golden Circle, $995, and we have a Diamonds VIP platform at the back as well. And for this show, people will be able to buy early entry tickets, which will mean the super fans can get in ahead of everybody else. Finally, I think we'll be making some announcements exclusively with BASSEM Entertainment, some big Rihanna announcements further down the line, some competitions and a few other things, so people should stay tuned to BASSEM Entertainment. Later on.
We'll keep bringing you more inside info on what is sure to be one of this year's most memorable concerts. And apparently, Rihanna isn't the only megastar who will be paying us a visit soon. So make sure you watch this space for more breaking news from Flash Entertainment.
And speaking of Flash, they hosted the world's biggest hard rock band, Metallica, in a breathtaking sold-out show in 2011 that blew away the fans and band alike. So 2 years later, when Metallica returned to rock the Emirates, it was only fitting that we get personal with the frontman about his music, life, and rumors that the band is splitting up. Okay, I'm truly freaking out here because I am with a serious legend. James, thanks so much for agreeing to do this interview. I think it's the first time I'm actually starstruck.
Wow. I'm that special.
And the last time you were here, I had such a strange concert experience because I was talking to the fans surrounding us and everyone had flown in from a different country. That never happens. Were you surprised by all the different fans that came and flown in? Did you know you had so many fans in this region?
No. It's an amazing eclectic collection of Metallica family from all around the area. And we didn't know that until, first of all, we do a little meet and greet for our Met Club people and, you know, meeting people from Lebanon and all the different countries around here. I was blown away.
So you're just so open with the media, which I think is amazing and something so rare to see. But have you ever regretted how much exposure there is with, the, you know, some kind of monster and you're going through rehab? Was that something you ever looked back upon and wished that hadn't happened? Or were you quite happy about how honest you've been about your life and your...
It's a good question. I think the more honest I am with myself and everyone around me, the more they can help me stay honest as well. There's a little, you can't go back. I mean, as simple as that. And this day and age, if you don't speak for yourself, someone else is gonna speak for you and they'll make stuff up about you. And it's just better just to put yourself out there. I think it's scary at first, but I think it's extremely worth it.
You just seem such a calm version of yourself. And you know, I'm wondering with, you know, hopefully a new album coming out this year, I do want to know about that. Are we still going to be hearing that, you know, that aggression and that anger coming through the music? Because I don't know if we'll survive without it.
That's a part of me forever. Fortunately, you know, the blessing and the curse, you know, it is a part of me. And I know a lot of fans do relate to that.
Absolutely.
And hopefully to some of the answers I've found and to some of the, the sad, mellow songs that we have as well. You know, we're really honest with ourselves about music and lyrics. And because of that, we have a lot of loyal fans that are honest with themselves as well. And at the end of the day, that's a great connection to have.
Or releasing that, you know, anger in a mosh pit or whatever. When's the last time you went to a concert and actually got in that mosh pit? A little stage diving.
In the mosh pit, it's been a long while. I tried doing it. I tried doing it at out on tour on one of our concerts. We had the snake pit out in front, and once some of the other bands were playing, I think it was Mastodon was playing, and I wanted to see them, so I put on some mask, and I went out, you know, like a skeleton mask, and went out in the crowd, and it didn't last too long.
No.
People kind of knew who it was. But, I mean, there's plenty of concerts that I go to that I have a blast and have a good time at. You know, not so much down in the pit anymore, but, you know, trying not to cause too much attention down there.
So there was an April Fool's joke, which freaked me out, that Metallica was splitting up. There's absolutely no truth to that, right? I mean, you guys aren't even thinking about that, right?
We already tried that. It didn't work.
Yeah.
You saw some kind of monster, possibly. There's no plans for that. April Fool's is always fun, and there's thousands and thousands, because of the internet now, lots of great ones.
So once a musician, always a musician?
Just no, you don't retire from music. I mean, you just don't. I mean, you can't. Whether it's being on the road or staying, just writing, I mean, whatever it is, we'll be doing music.
So tell me about the upcoming album, because there's so many rumors. I've heard there is a release date, tentative 2013. No, don't laugh.
We haven't even started writing it. I mean, we're going through riffs. We have like 800 and something riffs we're going through. Lots of ideas. We're really excited about it, but, you know, doing concerts here and there, trying to get back in the studio, get some stuff done. It's all really exciting, but it gets done on Metallica time, which is usually not, it's not really scheduled.
When
it's done, it's done.
You have time on your hands.
Well, when it's good, then it'll be done.
So we do have a 3D movie releasing this summer, though,
right?
Through the
Never.
So tell me about that. What should we expect?
The idea behind it was a best of concert. A lot of younger fans haven't got to see all of the things from the past, like the Injustice for All, the Ride the Lightning, all of the stage props that we had, the destruction scene, Master Puppets crosses, lots of things like that. Doing a best of concert and touring that, and then we thought, well, if we're going to do that, why don't we film it? And then, well, let's film 3D, and it kind of swapped its order. So we're making the movie and then possibly touring it afterward. And there's also a narrative that goes along with it. So there's a story about a runner or someone who works at the show who's sent out to get something and a big adventure that he goes on.
Now, just one last thing. What is one thing that nobody knows about Metallica?
Wow, one thing that Metallica, nobody knows about Metallica. You just stumped me with something.
Woo!
I think we've revealed almost everything we can to the world.
A silly fact.
A silly fact. I don't know. There's probably some music in our computers or iPads that don't really get advertised too much, but you know.
You got Hanson playing, bop, yeah, that kind of stuff, or what are we thinking?
Like ABBA or something like that.
Oh, that's sweet.
Well, that is it for tonight's show, but don't worry, the celeb action is only gonna get more intense this week with Justin Bieber, Ashanti, Susan Sarandon, David Guetta, Estelle, and Jesse Metcalf all here at DXB to do their thing.
And yes, those interviews will be coming your way, but in the meantime, for more breaking entertainment news, keep an eye out on our Facebook page, facebook.com/thatsEDXB.
Now you have yourselves a fantastic weekend. While we dash off to meet Ashanti, we're leaving you with her latest video, Never Should Have. Good night.
Good night. You were all